silver lining is that it has exposed late night hosts just for the lazy right. hacks yeah. that they are. When you take away the hype, the hundreds of employees, writers, producers, they don't have, they've got nothing. They can't do it. Here's my question of the day. We're going to move on and talk about the whole YouTube landscape and network television landscape. The coronavirus, it's essentially forced all late night hosts now to become YouTubers. So today, yeah. in 2020, thanks to corona, we are all YouTubers. How do you think these hosts stack up? Or you know what? I know you're just going to say they suck. So I need a more pointed question. Specifically, which host do you think stacks up the best without a massive staff and audience laughter cues? Colbert, Kimmel, Noah, B? Who do you think is doing
hard to get out.
The best job? Silver lining here. Silver lining. Yes. Obviously, we're not happy about the coronavirus.
No,
no one
of course
here
not.
Is. We're not saying
of
that. But the silver lining is that it has exposed late night hosts and yeah. wannabe late night hosts on CNN, on the most trusted name in news. just for the, I wouldn't say talentless, but the lazy right. hacks yeah. that they are. And that's why we're trying to do things a little bit differently yeah. here. We yeah. see that all of these folks who have all of this staff, all of this budget, they're just broadcasting from their bathtub now. They're just broadcasting from home. And we decided, you know what? We can take an acceptable risk. We can come in here. We can quarantine in the office. We can quarantine at home. And try to make sure that you aren't just left out in the cold because Colbert can't find it within him as he shuffles past the $15 million annual salary to find a microphone that he could use to broadcast. They basically have a vacation.
Yeah. No, absolutely.
So let's go right now to see, in case you don't believe me, just how lazy late night has become.
To help prevent the spread of COVID-19, I'm now shooting the show with a safe, minimal crew of my husband and the creatures of the forest. Oh, who's this?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Late Night from...
It's on NBC.
...my hallway.
National welcome television. To the Tonight Show. I'm so excited to be doing
He's
the show.
He's not supposed
from my
to go to a
room.
Kindergarten.
I mean, living room.
Hi. He's the cubby keeper.
Welcome
he has to.
To my bathroom. I'm your host, Stephen Colbert. You're watching a very special social distancing edition of The Late Show, or... as I now call it, The Lather Show with Scrub and Colbert.
So I'm doing the show from my house in New York, and this is how crazy New York traffic is. I'm doing the show from my living room, and I was still 20 minutes late getting in.
I'm a hallucination.
I love the camera guys.
By you isolating yourself.
Okay.
Hey, man. Don't you ever let me catch you prescribing shit in my ward, cuz.
Never funny accidentally.
Now let me get that seat.
Never stumbled across funny, Trevor Noah.
My first guest tonight, as you can see, is Mr. Bubble, followed by a musical performance by the legendary duo Head and Shoulders. Thanks, guys.
I don't like it. I don't want it. Shut it off. And here's something
so
with
bad.
Trevor Noah. A lot of people don't realize this. People who haven't performed, we've had this struggle quite a bit when people taking part in sketches here because a lot of people here aren't actors and we're kind of fitting them in.
That would be me.
If they've performed in rooms, for example, or in a green screen room that's supposed to take place outside,
mm-hmm.
Where people sort of talk like this, and I go, no, listen, people don't see you in a studio in a green screen room. They're going to see you outside in the forest, or they're going to see you in a crowded mall. That's what we're doing with the green screen. So you need to project.
Right.
You need to project the kind of volume and the kind of intensity that your audience is expecting given that scenario, because a lot of people get in and they start talking like this. That's what Trevor Noah is doing.
Yeah.
He's doing his show as though his wife is mad in the next room. I don't know if he's married. His boyfriend's mad in the next room.
Yeah.
If he catches
it's 2020.
Him. It's just when you take away the hype, the hundreds of employees, writers, producers, they've got nothing. They can't do it. For a reference point, by the way, while we're talking about this, a single episode of Trevor Noah's show has 21 writers, 14 producers,
whoa.
Cast members, technical crew, all of that. When you look at the entire staff of a show like Colbert's, you're talking about over 100 people.
That's
and the budget
insane.
These shows have, tens of millions of dollars.
Wow.
Tonight's show alone is $75 million. $75 million.
Wow.
You couldn't find a camera guy who had more than an iPhone and laughs like Jimmy Fallon
right.
behind the camera. It's terrible when it's in front of the camera, but behind
right.
the camera when it's...
Yeah.
Still late? No! Shut up!
Stop.
And here's something, too.
It's not like this should have caught them off guard, right? I mean, they knew that something like this was coming with the coronavirus out there, and
right.
they didn't have a technical team that said, hey, give us half a day, we'll set your house up.
They do not respect the audience. This is the issue. I don't think they respect the audience. These hosts make millions.
Okay.
Some of them make over $10 million a year. That's important to note. They could forego half of that salary to have someone set up a remote studio, by the way. This, everything here, this entire office, the people out there in the edit bay, this entire studio, our monthly, we could do all of that for a fraction of their salary. And here's an important note, too, because I'm kind of joking about it, but we're all YouTubers. Mm-hmm. They don't stack up well. They're not doing well. Their views aren't good. When you remove the paid views, it's even less. When you remove the algorithms which favor them because they're advertiser friendly, it's even less. See, one thing we also know about Trevor Noah: horrible design, horrible decor.
That's very
what is
bad.
That? Is it modern? Is it contemporary? Yeah. I don't know. But he has a pube stash.
So I guess he's not gay.
I have no idea.
Oh, you know what?
How does that work?
That's right.
He could just be the man in the cup. He could just be gay. Not all gay. Why are you so prejudiced? Not all gays are good at design.
That's a positive.
That's like assuming that an uncharacteristically high number of them get AIDS, except less accurate. So why when you look at NBC, their parent companies, NBC, ABC, CBS, NBC, Vox, right? Universal.
Right.
Then ABC is Disney. Gosh, we've been in lawsuits with all of these.
Yeah, we have. Yeah.
All of them. Every single one.
You're just naming your lawsuits.
My half Asian lawyer is in digital court right now.
Yep.
They're all trying to squeeze YouTube and Google, right? Trying to get them to favor these shows because I think they know that they don't have the stuff to compete. Mm. That's why they want to force shows like this out. Not just shows like this, but there are plenty. Take examples like PewDiePie. Take examples of whoever. They turn on a camera and start live streaming video games. And I think there's a race to the middle, right? There's a split the difference with some pre-produced content, some decent budget, but also, hopefully, talent. Now, by the way, hit the notification bell if you are not joining Mug Club. Of course, Mug Club Quarantine is the promo code for the month. But hit the notification bell. Hit all notifications because subscriptions don't mean a whole lot. And do subscribe to Crowder Bits because that will be we'll be uploading a lot of content.
A lot of extra stuff over there.
This month. Here's something else that I think it's really showcased. Not only how unfunny they are. I mean, I don't think we need a coronavirus to pull back the curtain on Samantha Bee.
Yeah, it's not a big reveal.
No, I don't think so much. If anything, for hers, it's an improvement.
Yeah, it's the best show she's done in a while.
Well, because no one's watching, is what I'm saying. Like, it's an improvement because if a horribly unfunny diversity hire screams alone in a forest. So, as their production value has gone down and they don't respect their audience, we adore you. We genuinely do. We are so grateful. They've also become lazier, and this is a silver lining, in hiding their political bias. So Kimmel had former presidential candidate Pete Buttigieg on to host his show initially when they were concerned about the Chinese virus. Here you go.
Now, this is a strange night for us, not only because this is my first time hosting a talk show, because we're doing it without a regular studio audience. Due to public health concerns over the coronavirus,
few staffers
we have canceled the studio audience t-shirts. Tonight. Let's do this together. Who's with me?
Here's this big joke, watch.
Right. Full disclosure, none of those people are here. But when you don't have a real audience, you have to fake one, just like Trump's inauguration.
Big toothy smile. Screw you, Pete.
Screw you hard. Screw you hard with someone else's pecker is my point. I want nothing to do with you.
Right.
This is not anyone
weird.
Here. I have no idea. It is so bad. But think about this. They're having, why else, why would you have Pete Buttigieg on? If not for the fact, they're just trying to push a political agenda right now. They used to try and obfuscate a little bit. No, we're just going for comedy. Really? Okay, so you're a late night show and you're just chasing comedy and you thought... Sub-host Pete Buttigieg. That is like the, we used to know like stand-up comics on the road who would have the most horrible opener just to guarantee job security. Either that is what's going on, or Jimmy Kimmel actually thinks Pete Buttigieg is funny, or he's pushing a political agenda. You decide which one is more offensive. None of them are good. None of them are good options. And now here you go. Is this another Kimmel? Yeah, that's right. He's been interviewing people from his home.
Yes.
And here you go. He is, again, at one point, just trying to say, well, it's not about left or right. It's about being a human, as he cries about Cecil the Lion. Now he's basically been helping Biden tape awkward campaign commercials. That's what it's become. Here you go.
Joe Biden.
What's that hat you have on?
And New York Mets. It's supposed to be opening day.
Opening day.
Wow.
That was like the Saw character.
That's terrifying.
I'll tell you what, but it's a way to be able to sleep with my wife.
Whoa!
She's a Philly girl.
Oh, okay.
If I work for the Phillies, I'd be out of luck,
she likes the hat.
Do you think
that's
Trump
a brand
will
new
debate
hat.
You, or do you think he will try to dodge that?
I don't know. I hope we debate. I'm looking forward to that.
I don't think you are, Joe. I don't think you and your plucked off a Cheshire Cat alarm clock mouthpiece... really want to debate Donald Trump. It is remarkable
like
to
cartoon.
Me. By the way, that's what I had if I want to sleep with my wife. She's a 9-year-old Philly girl. I mean, she's a girl. She's a girl from Philly. What? What happened?
Oh, geez.
Why'd I stop?
Again.
It is remarkable to me that in all this, I mean, did they have, why don't they have Donald Trump on?
Right.
They could have had a lot
I don't
of
care if they're chasing the funny. I don't yeah. care. But listen, can we be honest here? Whether you agree with President Trump or not, by every available metric, it's going to be a funnier show
it
with
is.
Donald Trump
funny.
Than it's going to be with yeah. Joe Biden. Yeah. And something else, too. Let's go to, he's not a late night host, but you know he wants to be. Is he, do we, that's right. It's always, it's like, I feel like a carnival barker guessing someone's weight because it's always different every broadcast. With Brian Stelter, here he is having Stephen King on with the Chiron when real life is even scarier than fiction. Ooh. Let's watch this.
Whoa. Stephen, thank you for being here. I wonder what you say about an experience.
He looks like
where
an angry, denimed lesbian.
Something Stephen scarier King. Than
he looks like Stephen King transitioning to woman.
Well, actually, I did imagine it. I've heard a lot about
that's
that.
That's true. That's true.
Jeez. It's 3 or 4 weeks, people are saying to me, we're living in a Stephen King world, and all I can say is, boy, I wish we weren't.
Really? This is a Stephen, hold on a second. This is a Stephen King world, and truth is stranger than fiction. We're talking about a virus that is, at this point, at the point of this recording, nowhere near the magnitude of a rough flu season. You had a film with a rapist clown.
Right.
It's true.
Yeah. And The Stand, where 99% of humanity
right.
died.
Right.
There are
right.
like 300 people left.
We're yeah. equating that yeah. with the sniffles.
Yeah.
And the reason they are is because they want to blame it on Donald Trump.
Well,
they want to act as though, well, this is actually worse than The Stand. This is actually worse than It. That's right. That's what it was called.
Yeah, yeah.
This is worse than It yeah. because it's Donald Trump's fault.
Yeah.
No mention of China, by the way. If Stephen King wants to talk about some sinister plot, right, some world order, some yeah. global conspiracy, how about the people who lied about the virus in the first place and killed the guy who tried to blow the whistle? Couldn't that deserve a few pages in there? Whatever. Who do you think stacks up the best out of all these shows? I want you to tune in for a little bit. I'm sorry, just a little bit. Flip through CNN, Fox News, ABC, NBC, CBS, all the late night shows, and tell me who you think is doing the best job adapting right now. And this yeah. is important because it's not the strongest animal that survives. It's the animal who can most effectively adapt. And we've consistently yeah. tried to do that and be ahead of the curve, not because we're afraid of going away, but because we really do live to serve you guys. We always think, hey, listen, we have been supported from the ground up from yeah. viewers. You have created this show. We weren't thrust upon you by a network who decided to put us in a time slot that people were watching anyway. And so we've had to earn our keep. We've had to earn your viewership. These people don't. Now you see how lazy they are. And that's why, of course, we're off offering this month, the whole month, free Mug Club month, hashtag Mug Club Quarantine.
Quarantine.
We're doing Monday through Thursday evening yeah. shows available on YouTube in front of the paywall. We're adding 3 shows a week. You can go to latifcredit.com/schedule every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Yep. The whole
Boom.
Month of April, 10 a.m. Eastern,
Bunch
and Crowder Bits, Apple. And we are trying to give you as much content as possible. And I appreciate a lot of you saying, you know, look out for your health. I am looking, I'm treating it like 2-a-days. I am sleeping right, I am eating right,
there
and I'm
go.
Very, very unhappy. But as long as I am serving
like
you, because all you have, this is the reason we're doing this is because I watch late night religiously. I have to.
Yeah.
It's not, my,
That's not
you
fun.
Don't know how dark it's inside my head sometime, okay? And so because of that, I was going, this is all everyone has out there. We have to give them more. And so
it's
we're
true.
Going to give you everything we have this month because I know a lot of you are out of work. I know a lot of you run businesses that may not open up again anytime soon.
Right.
And so if I have to work 12, 14, 16 hour days for a month, you know what? I'll take it if it helps you guys. And then I'll have a long weekend. Hey, if you enjoyed this show, subscribe or hit the notification bell. It's cold in here, so I'm covering my nips. Hit all notifications on the notification bell because apparently subscriptions don't mean a whole lot. Look, there are video. What they're playing in boxes? Is that what's happening, Quarter Black Garrett? There are videos playing in boxes. You should click one of them. Maybe one of them's a mystery box. Could cut glass with these things.